Let's get ready to rumble!
Yo, yo.
What's up, everybody? This is Inside the Ring. We are your hosts. I am Mike. With me, with my tag team partner, Ray.
Yo, yo.
How you doing today?
Good, good, good. How are you?
Doing fantastic.
All right.
So we got an interesting show for you today. We're going to go ahead and start with the review for Raw, and then we'll work our way to SmackDown. We got some interviews. We were at Raw last Monday night at the Staples Center. Thank you, Denver Nuggets.
Yes, yes, baby.
But unfortunately, I think I had a better time actually seeing the other people, like the fights that were happening in the audience.
The big dude.
More than the actual show. The show, I thought, was pretty much a disappointment. So, and then we'll follow up with some interviews, like I said, and then we'll follow up with a review, a spoiler that I got from Raw. We'll just go over with the results. Got some news for you. Got some rumors for you. And we're also going to go over with the UFC fight. What was it, 98?
UFC 98.
And also Dream 9 over there in Japan. So, what we'll do is I got the Raw results here. So, again, I thought it was a very disappointing Raw, I felt. All eyes was on this Raw in particular, only because Vince was making a big stink in the media in every single format he can get. And I don't think he pulled it off. I think he failed miserably.
Well, I think the skit that they put on the beginning of the show was horrible. I think that was all they had, and they blew it.
I think Vince should have took the high road and should have just forget about the little skit, the little Stan Kroenke, you know, little impersonator, just like you said last week. What did you say last week?
That they were going to do it.
Okay, and what happened?
They did it.
They did it.
And it was a piece of crap.
Yes, and not only did they have Stan Kroenke, but they also had Jack Nicholson.
Yeah, that was horrible, too. They didn't say one word. They didn't even show his name on the big screen.
No, they didn't. I thought that was pretty funny, but I think, you know, he's pretty well known if it was actually him.
But they showed the other two people's names. Why couldn't they show his?
And Jerry Buzz, and that was the... None of them looked like, for the exception of Jack Nicholson, but none of them looked like who they were supposed to be.
No, not even
the Stan Kroenke impersonator.
That was horrible.
That was horrible. Vince should have took the high road on that, but... They opened the show up with the Divas Championship with your girl Maryse.
Oh, my baby.
And the Kelly Kelly.
Kelly Kelly's not too bad.
What did you think about that match?
You know what? It's hard to say. I think the Divas division is really strong, but it's just there's no story behind any of these fights. Every week there's just a new fight, and there's nothing behind it. I think the wrestling is a lot better than it has ever been, but... I just think that it was just a waste of time because there's really nothing going behind those matches.
There's not. There's not really. You know, I'm against the storylines, but they are kind of lacking in a direction.
Yes, the storyline and direction is wrong for them, but their wrestling matches are great. I think the characters and as many women as they have now is a lot better than what they used to.
The girls' match, I thought it was kind of interesting. I mean, usually they would put the girls' match in the middle of the show. That's for people to go up, go take a piss, go to use the restroom,
right?
Or go buy some food or whatever,
right?
But they had that in the very opening. Now, do you think that was wise of them?
I actually do, because that just what you just said about how the girls always being the bathroom break match is how I always saw them as. And now that the division's better and the talent is better, I think that they should get the opening spot and start off the show and start off a good show. If they had a good show going. But just like I say, the only problem with the women's division is just story. I mean, every week the women's change and the matches change, and it's Maryse just destroying everybody with no story behind it.
So the referee disqualifies Maryse, and Kelly Kelly wins by DQ. Right after that, lo and behold, they go ahead and they have a storyline build up, and that was with Goldust and Hornswoggle with the two Bella twins, which, you know, I don't want to bring up the storylines because, again, I'm against it, but I just had to bring this up, the Goldust situation. We were talking about it on Raw as we were watching it go down.
Yeah.
And it seems to me that they're bringing back that little speech impediment, you know.
I hate that thing.
From years
horrible.
Ago.
It's horrible.
You know, Goldust is looking good. He's lost some weight.
He's faster.
He's a little quicker now on his feet. That little wig that he has, though, is not as luxurious as it was back in the 90s, you know.
Yeah.
And it looks a little frazzled now. He looks like he's a little hungover with that wig. I really don't like that comedy anymore. I kind of like the dark Goldust.
His original character.
Right.
The Hollywood.
Right. I like that darker Goldust, and now it's more of a light Goldust. And now, even worse, they put him with the midget.
That's I can't stand that.
Finley just got rid of him, and now they put it on Goldust.
I just think that bringing back Goldust in shape should have been different. It should have... I know WWE right now has a lot of good heels, but they could use another one, especially with the talents and the experience of Goldust, and I think that's just a waste of time.
So the next match was the Triple Threat match. The winner receives the U.S. Championship next week. That was between Matt Hardy, William Regal, and Kofi Kingston. What did you think about that one?
No comment. I didn't like it at all.
I didn't really like it at all either, but I will tell you, though, Kofi Kingston's... theme song. I'm kind of digging it.
Oh, that song is great. But Kofi, man, he's the new Shelton Benjamin, man. He is the new showstopper. He's gonna explode, man, later on.
And right after that was, lo and behold, another storyline build-up. That was when Ric Flair comes out and does his little, stroke in the middle of the ring, you know?
All right.
The next match after that was the mixed tag team match. And that was with our boy Santino Marella.
Yes.
I love that guy. That guy is so great on the mic. With Mickie James, and she is so hot.
Mickie James. I don't mind that. That is nice.
I love Mickie James. She's so hot. You know, there's rumors that Mickie James and John Cena hooked up.
Oh, no. Please, no.
Yeah. That's the rumors going around. Against Chavo Guerrero and Beth Phoenix with Rosa Mendez. Ringside. I don't know. I'm kind of getting a little mixed signals on that one.
No.
Sometimes she looks good, sometimes she don't.
I like Beth better than that chick.
Beth is, you know, call me...
Slim her down a little bit. She's a little hot piece.
Call me crazy. Yeah. I think so. I think it depends on what time of the day it is. But turns out that Santino won that one as well. And he is going to be facing Vicky Guerrero at the new Extreme Rules... in a
pigpen match,
hog pen match. Yeah, and I'd love it when he does a squealing.
I think that's great. I'm telling you that Chavo and Santino works. That feud works, especially when you have Vicky in the background like that, bringing that story together.
And lo and behold, right after that was a backstage little ditty again, storyline build up.
Yeah,
but you know
it was
what?
Probably short on Raw, but it was a lot longer than that in person.
You know, but I don't recall this one. I don't know what we were doing or what, but this was with the Big Show tells The Miz that he doesn't like him.
Oh, yeah, they didn't show that part.
They didn't show that part at all.
No.
So that might have been an add-on after the show, during the show. I don't know, but they really didn't show that part. And then you had the next match after that was the Goldust and Hornswoggle versus Brian Kendrick and Festus.
Yeah, you can just skip that.
Yeah, I think I was showing you at Raw there.